out of the box, the Godot script editor doesn't include types. So if I start typing input, and you see that there, great. You've got a method input, a callback that we know exists, and we've got event. And you can say if event dot is action pressed, you know, UI accept, and then you can say pass, you know, do the thing. And we're used to that. That's what's in the box. It looks clean. It is a lot like Ruby, Python, other scripting languages. But something I've been using and wanted to make more apparent is available is that you can turn on type hinting. If you're not familiar with type hinting, it's when your code lets you know what it is that's being passed in. And it raises the visibility of what's available and what's being returned. And I think it helps write better code. Coming from 15 years of using Ruby, where we don't have static typing, to in the last 5 years doing a lot more TypeScript at my day job, I've come to prefer having the type signatures available. So if you go to editor settings, and I just type in type, but let's go ahead and walk there ourselves. You go down to text editor completion, there's this option to add type hints. If true, static typing hints, such as the return value, when using code auto-completion or in creating them, are available. So if we click, if we check that to true and click close, now if I type func and we do that input callback, we see right away that this callback takes an input event, like I said earlier when I added it manually, and it returns void. So we know we don't have to return anything special. This is really helpful because now if I want to go and know what the heck is an input event, I can easily search that. So it just raises, it increases the visibility of the classes and that are being used, and I think has helped me learn more about the data structures and class structure that exists. So also, you know, you can write your own methods that take, let's say, you know, we just have a damage callback, and we have strength, and we know that that's an int, and it returns void, and we'll just say, you know, print debug strength. This becomes really helpful, knowing that that's an int, because if I come down, if I go to another part in the code and call damage, it knows that it's an int, and that type hinting is really helpful. So then if I were to pass in, you know, foo as a string, when it's expecting an int, we get this error, cannot pass value of string as int. Now, if we got rid of the type signature, it takes anything, and that does an error. But then if we were to do math, like 1 plus strength, you know, that type of thing, we would get an error, which, you know, would be, we can actually run it and see what happens. So I'll just press a key. Well, it actually errored there. So invalid operands int and string in operator plus. Now, if we go ahead and add back our type hinting, we catch the error sooner. So then we know, oh, this has to be an integer. We run it, and we press input. It goes and adds them. And that's doing it a whole bunch, but because it's on the input callback. But to me, this has been really helpful because it helps catch bugs earlier. It helps me write code better because when I call damage, I know that it does that, and maybe we could make it return the new health. Like, let's say we had var health and we set it to 5 by default, and then we say here health minus equals strength, and then maybe we have it return health. Right? Now if we go here and we type damage and we do 1, we could see new health is equal to damage, and we can even write docs, we could say returns the new health after applying the damage. I found it really helpful to have the type signatures available and to be more explicit about the data that's expected. And the nice thing is too, you can still go ahead and write functions, you know, the thing, and use any And then you can check, like, if foo has method, you know, damage, then call damage, you know, whatever. That kind of thing. So, little tip for Godot and GDScript. Hope that helps. It's really helped me. All right, thanks. See ya. Bye.